story tonight. Just when you thought the left couldn't stoop any lower, Saturday Night Live's Pete Davidson mocked a Republican congressional candidate and war hero named Dan Crenshaw. Dan Crenshaw lost his eye in the war in Afghanistan. Watch SNL.
Kind of cool, Dan Crenshaw.
Oh, come on, man.
Yo, hold on. You may be surprised to hear he's a congressional candidate from Texas and not a hitman in a porno movie. I'm sorry, I know he lost his eye in war or whatever.
With me now, former military intelligence officer and Trump 2020 advisory board member, Steve Rogers. Steve, thanks for joining me.
Oh, you're welcome. Thank you very much.
All right, Steve, as a U.S. military veteran yourself, what do you feel when you see this? It seems like our entire country was disgusted when they saw this. What do you feel when you see this?
Not only saddened that this individual went so far as to mock this hero, but the laughs. The people who laughed and who seemed to have enjoyed it. I've got to tell you, Liz, look at the contrast between President Trump praising every veteran in every city and every town across this country and these people who represent the Democrat socialists mocking disabled veterans who fought for this country.
Right. It's just heartbreaking. I mean, I come from a military family. My husband's military. It's awful to think that someone's service and their sacrifice, when they sacrifice their own body for our freedoms, that's the subject of Democrats' ridicule. It's just horrifying. This man, Dan Crenshaw, he was on patrol in Afghanistan. I want to tell his story so that people know what happened. He was on patrol in Afghanistan. It was his third deployment when this happened. He stepped on an IED, underwent emergency surgery, lost his eye. His other eye, he was told he would be blind forever. He had surgery. He has some sight in that eye. He redeployed a year later. He redeployed twice after suffering this injury. Twice. He has served 5 tours of duty overseas in war zones. I'm speechless.
Liz, every parent and every relative of a combat veteran, whether you're Republican or Democrat, must look at this and condemn it. And I'm hoping to God they condemn it at the polls tomorrow. This is outrageous. This is an assault, not on a political party, on the United States of America and our honorable veterans.
Right, it is. And Pete Davidson, who is the SNL comedian that made this quote-unquote joke, he should know better than this. His father was a firefighter in New York City on September 11, 2001. His father lost his life on September 11th trying to rescue people from the Twin Towers. Dan Crenshaw served and sacrificed essentially to avenge Pete's father. I mean, of all people, he should know better than this.
You know, Liz, you said it in your opening. How low will they go? They are morally bankrupt. And I would hope to God that the people who laughed at this are going to go home and maybe see you on the air and understand, wow, we should have not laughed at that. But tomorrow's the big day, isn't it? Tomorrow's the day where you can fight back and answer this stuff back.
Right. And this is the choice I think we have at the polls tomorrow. And this race is just a microcosm of races all across the country. On one hand, we have Democrats like Pete Davidson who are making fun of someone's service and sacrifice. On the other hand, this is the response from Crunch. I absolutely love this. This is what he tweeted in response to this attack on his service. He said, "Good rule in life. I try hard not to offend. I try harder not to be offended. That being said, I hope NBC's NSL recognizes that vets don't deserve to see their wounds used as punchlines for bad jokes." Steve, he went on to say he doesn't want an apology. He said he doesn't like our apology culture where people are forced to make apologies every time somebody else doesn't like what they say. Talk about a class act. I mean, of any person in our country who deserves an apology, it's this guy.
The train left the station. That's what he's saying. And an apology and anything else is not going to change where that train is headed. And that train is headed towards destruction. So God bless him and God bless every veteran who continue to stand for the American flag and our veterans.
Right. And we talked about this just briefly with Boyd Matheson in the previous segment. I mean, these men and women in our military that serve and sacrifice, get wounded, lay down their lives. They're the reason that we have this freedom to exercise our votes. They're the reason that we're allowed to have the disagreements politically that we have in this nation. If they didn't serve and sacrifice and protect our freedom and lay down their lives to secure our liberty, we wouldn't even be allowed, you know, to have a show like this, to exercise our free speech, to criticize the president, to criticize the opposition party without fearing for our lives.
Liz, when I was mobilized in the Navy, my son was in the United States Marines in a combat infantry division in Iraq. And when he came home, he says, Dad, I'll tell you, it's all worth it. It's all worth our freedom. It's worth our liberty. We have to continue to fight the good fight and keep America strong. That's the kind of veterans that are really standing on that Constitution we so love, and they are preserving it for us.
Right. Exactly. Like I said, it's very simple. Choice between upholding our Constitution and appreciating the men and women in our military or the disrespect we see from the left. Steve, thank you for your service to our nation. Thank your son for his service to our nation, and we'll talk to you soon. On that note, we're going to turn to another story.